my fellow gamers, and welcome once again to Better Philosophy Dose. Today we are back for the 95th episode in the Let's Play called Road to 1 Million Population on the Hard Mode in the City of Bedrock. The population is now at 910,000+. This is thanks to some new regions that I managed to first terraform and then set up the road and highway network and then zone on them the new districts. Now, there is a lot that I have to talk about in this episode. First up, there is a new mod that I have to add, and then a new mod because I added that mod. So I changed the traffic manager from the regular version to the Traffic Manager Peasant Edition Labs. This is because to allow me to use the mod which allows for more vehicles, which is called More Vehicles. And it allows the vehicles to go up to 64,000. Currently, I am at 22,200 vehicles, up from 16,300 or so. So about a 33% increase in vehicles, and this has reduced the average traffic flow in my city. Although, currently it says 83%, I could have swore a moment ago it was 70-something, but you can see that there are some places that are heavily impacted by the additional traffic. Now, this area has recently been built up, as you can see here. These are the new districts. You remember these from the previous episode, but there are three new ones here. One called Yuka, one called Urbania, one called Tampere. Now, Urbania comes as a subscriber suggestion. I think it's an area in Italy, if I'm not mistaken. Yuka is a name from one of my subscribers and followers, and the Tampere is the name of the area where Colossal Order have their HQ. Like I said, more than 910, currently 916,000 population, and you can see 4,000 going up, so now it dropped to 200, weird that happened. In any event, it will now soon go to 917,000. I have managed to clear up this area here, but I've raised it up a little bit compared to the previous areas, so that I have somewhere to use up all this ground when I'm terraforming these mountains here. Here on the edge, I'm going to do something interesting. I will show you that in the next episode, because I tested it out in one go and I didn't like the product, so I bulldozed it down, terraformed it, but in the next episode you'll see what I'm going to build over here. As for this area, it's prepared and I can continue with the districts. This one is called Name Me Please. It means that I really need more suggestions from you about how to name these districts. Now, I do seem to have a little bit more of than I need of goods in the factories, so I'm going to turn off the industrial space planning in a few places to make sure that this is evened out. The thing is that there is a lot of traffic here because of all these new districts, but once they settle down, they are going to be able to have better traffic, although I do need to do some more manual tinkering with the traffic manager mod in order to make sure that all these intersections between the highways work properly. When talking about the mods, I also need the loading screen mod because it's a requirement to use the more vehicles mod. One of the questions was to show the zoning overlay in one of my episodes, so I'm going to show you that right now. As you can see, the green, of course, is residential, offices in blue, dark blue commercial areas, and industrial buildings with the dark orange. Now, the industrial buildings are all generic industry producing goods. One of my subscribers actually pointed out that maybe I should get more of the specialized industry so that I could make all the products that my generic industry needs in order to be able to produce these goods, so I would import less locally. As you can see, I have around 40,000 imports at the moment. But the problem with that is that even when you do not have the products being imported, you still need to import the raw materials from which the products are made in specialized industry. And for me to import those, again, I would have import. And there would just be a problem with the workers, because specialized industry requires a lot of uneducated workers. And I do not have the ability to give that industry uneducated workers, because I'm mostly at highly educated. Between the last and this episode, I did redo the metros a little bit. I have a different setup of metro lines, and now more people are using the metro. It's now at 6,500, but with the free public transportation turned on in all these districts to make sure that the maximum number of sims will use the public transportation. So it is a little bit better on usage, and that could be attributed to the fact that there are a lot more jobs now. In this episode, you can see that I have jobs available 671,000, with the unemployment being at 8%. Now, 8% comes because of the change to go with just two rows of residential instead of the previous three rows that I did in the other areas around the city, because I noticed that sooner or later I always need to make a purely office district in order to make sure to have more jobs. I have that one up there, I have these down here, a lot of offices here, then a few here, and in order to avoid making more of them over here, I decided to reduce the number of residential buildings down to 2 lines, and so far it's been doing its job well, and currently I am at 8% unemployment, but as soon as I make more buildings over here, there are going to be more jobs, it's going to drop down to 7%. To make sure that there is a good transport line of products, I've made sure to get the railway system to keep going over here through and in between these highways, and I have two additional cargo train stations in these areas here, which are helping to get the products here for the industry to be able to be operational. And this industry seems to be building too many goods, and with the turning off of the industrial space planning, the amount of goods should drop. I'll turn off two more. The thing is that without the more vehicles mod, I would never have been able to get rid of all the icons saying not enough goods or buyers for products, that is from the industry, the ones that you're currently seeing, because there were simply not enough vehicles. The 16k vehicles were simply not enough to suffice for the entire city to have enough vehicles to move those goods around. So now with the extension to the more vehicles mod and the ability to have over 22,000 vehicles in the streets, this means that I am now finally able to make sure that those buildings are able to get transport, and now they do not create any more warning signs except when I overdo it with the industrial space planning policy. Now I should give you a nice shot of the city here. You can see from here the new districts being built over there, and currently with the population being at 917,500, I do believe that I'm going to need another area here to get to around 930,000, 40,000, I'm guessing 50, 60, 70 here, 80 here, and probably all the way here to get the full 1 million. Although I could be wrong, because sometimes they do seem to fit a lot more population, although when you take a look, this area here has 5,000 population, so you can get the idea just how much more space do I need to fill up in order to get to the full 1 million. It is interesting that this area here is the only one that has the problem with not enough buyers for products, but that is just because of some of these vehicles piling up here in the highways instead of going over here into this part of the city and make sure to transport the goods. But that's something that fixes itself up once all the vehicles are moved in, because a lot of vehicles are just currently passing through here to get to the newly built areas. Finish off this episode, I would once again have to ask you to give me more names for districts, as I'm running out of districts because I'm making small districts over here and need lots of names for these districts. I would like to thank you all for following this let's play, share it with your friends who might find it enjoyable. Thank you very much for watching, and please stay tuned for more episodes.